you follow the number one team in the nation. But let's talk about those preseason polls. The man next to me did not have North Carolina number one in the preseason. Neither did AP, neither did UPI, but you can't have veterans, a team that looks like they could play in the NBA. He's got a lot of work to do tonight, obviously.
Well, I think a key player tonight's going to be the seven-footer, the freshman, Gary Leonard. He may get a clinic 401 from Brad Daugherty on how to play the post, but that's going to be an important matchup. If Leonard gets into foul trouble, they do not have enough depth on that front court to be able to challenge North Carolina.
Players tonight, his name is Dick Lobdell. Dick.
And now for the starting lineups. First, for the Tar Heels, a forward, number 24, 6'10" junior from Kohler, Wisconsin, Jeff Wolf. For the Tigers, number 42, 6'7½" freshman from Washington, Missouri, Mike Sanbodie. For the Tar Heels, the other forward, number 35, 6'10" junior from Ashley, Pennsylvania, Dave Popson. For the Tigers, number 54, 6'9" senior from Belvedere, Illinois, Dan Bingenheimer. At center for the Tar Heels, number 42, 6'11½" senior from Black Mountain, North Carolina, Brad Daugherty. At center for the Tigers, number 52, 7-foot freshman from Bellevue, Illinois, Gary Leonard. At a guard position for the Tar Heels, number 25, 6'3" senior from Jenks, Oklahoma, Steve Hale. For the Tigers, number 3, a 6'6½" sophomore from Jamaica, New York, Derek Chivas. For the Tar Heels, number 30, 6'3" junior from Queens, New York, Kenny Smith. And for the Tigers, number 24, 6'2" sophomore from Detroit, Michigan, Lynn Hardy.
You're looking at the Tar Heels, who are averaging almost 109 points a game in their first two outings. And let's see if Missouri can test them. We are underway. The veterans, of course, the Tar Heels. Bingenheimer with the basketball, pull with Smith. Now he pulls it up. Taken away from him. And the Tigers control. Trying to chase it down. Here's Bingenheimer. Goes all the way up the glass and good. Dan Bingenheimer with the first 2 points.
Dan Bingenheimer, John, hit 2 big free throws to clinch the victory last year over North Carolina. They played in the Rainbow Classic in Hawaii.
Game tonight. It's good afternoon to the West. Fouls now on Steve Hale. He applies the defensive pressure out front. From outside, Bingenheimer with his second field goal. Missouri 4, Carolina 3.
Great execution against the diamond half-court trap. Good ball guard, Jeff Strong, their big scorer.
That's an offensive foul on Chavis, his second. You're right, Jeff Strong, the senior from Chattanooga, the team's leading scorer, is not on the trip. May not play till the first of the year. He has a stress fracture in his foot.
How big is he? He scored 24 points against Carolina when they beat him over in Hawaii. There's the position. Defensive players established.
All games this year, including the tournament. Here's Hardy with some open space. 6'3", Missouri.
Hardy's a guard that can play either the point position or the second guard slot.
Daugherty shot his block. Hale gets it back. Uses the glass. Can't hit. Wolf underneath. He scores. He's fouled.
John, that's that NBA size. They go with a few to have that real spark, especially offensively.
Leonard swings it to Hardy. He'll shoot from outside and hit. 8-5.
He's supposed to be a penetrator, not supposed to have great range as a shooter.
Pops and rebounds for Carolina. He loses. Bingenheimer slams it home. 6 points for Bingenheimer. The lead is 5. 10-5 Missouri.
North Carolina really very tentative and very aggressive.
Clock running with 14:35 to play first half. Good move by Hardy in the corner, but he's double teamed, goes low. Bingenheimer fouled and the basket is good. Bingenheimer already with 8 points.
John, I really like the court savvy of the kid Hardy from out of Detroit. He really knows when to shoot the perimeter jump shot and when to make the entry. He gets trapped, he dumps it inside, and there's just pure physical strength by Bingo Bingenheimer. Hey, he made the 2 clutch free throws in Hawaii to beat Carolina. And that was North Carolina's first loss last year in the Rainbow Classic.
Bingenheimer does not hit the 12-5.
The thing I like about Norm Stewart, all the coaches cry about being young.
Bingenheimer has 10.
Hey, Bingenheimer's playing like a superstar. Everybody, we got walking violation again. Everybody cries about being young. Norm Stewart says, Dick, we're flat out. We are starting five. That's the one area where negligent in. There's the shot block inside by Leonard.
Freshman Leonard blocking the shot of Doherty. Here's Hardy again against Hale, spinning down the lane. Good. Hardy with 6 points.
They're playing superb basketball. I know right now, Norm Stewart would like to stop this game and get over to the huddle. There hasn't been a better guard come out of high school basketball in the last decade.
Good move by Bingenheimer. He banks it in. Dan has 12 points.
Norm Stewart can't believe it. He's sitting there totally amazed. There's no way he can believe that Bingenheimer would be 6-for-6 in the first 7 minutes of action. Matter of time, Johnny. They're great. It's a spurt basketball team.
Look at Dan Bingenheimer. He has 14 points.
Hey, Bingenheimer, we're going to get you ready for the all-Rolls-Royce team. I mean, this guy is supposed to be like an all-Volkswagen, and here he is playing like a Rolls-Royce.
Doherty from short range misses. Again, the Tigers come together going for the rebound, and as a result, finally taken away. You see the tall trees inside. If it bounces twice, it's all over. It's also all over when Smith breaks away.
Coast to coast, tremendous speed, excellent timeout by Norm Stewart. He senses a run.
Tebow, they double team, set up the trap. Chivas has it. Hardy will shoot and score.
Got to make that open jump shot. When they rotate the ball,
led by 11, it's now Carolina by 3. The Tar Heels have come back. Inside, off the glass by Bingenheimer. He got away that time from Doherty. Doherty says he pushed off. He got the basket. 16 points for Bingenheimer.
Brad Doherty
up short. Musser with a rebound from Missouri. Back come the Tigers. Now Musser is a senior from St. Louis, number 25.
He's got excellent range as a shooter. Chivas doesn't seem to be looking for his shot at all. Kenny Smith, do you hear me? Pearl Washington.
What about Johnny Dawkins? Bingenheimer slams it home on the alley-oop. He has 18 points in the first half.
They ran a back screen. Someone forgot interrupting their half-court offensive game right now for Missouri.
3:33 remaining first half. Carolina has come back.
In Alaska, all I heard about is, Dick, wait till you see this exciting front court player, Mr. Chivas. He's going to be one of the best in the Big 8. And I know one thing. I watched him warm up. He is flat out a player. I don't care what he does here tonight. Derek Chivas is one of America's premier sophomores.
Smith,
scorer, one of the better scorers in the Big 8 Conference. Had 24 last year against North Carolina.
You saw checking back into the lineup was Curtis Hunter. Staff for Bingenheimer. He's 2 out of 5 at the line. 9 of 12 from the field.
North Carolina could rotate about 4 bodies at that number 3 that goes on. Walt Hazard was furious after being blown out by North Carolina. He thought they ran up the score.
And finally, somebody else scores for Missouri. It's Robin Davis, the freshman from Maywood, Illinois.
Good ball movement. If missed an attack at all, and they rely so much on a perimeter game, and when the jumper didn't fall down, it was lights out.
Norm Stewart has had 8-20 victory seasons at Missouri as the freshman Davis goes to the line, misses the foul shot. Bingenheimer gets it back.
Pretty soft defense, but an excellent baseline pass.
Missouri rebounds as the shot goes out of play. The horn. The first half is over. Norm Stewart's Tigers at 1 point led by 11, but they head to the locker room down by 8. Dean Smith and Carolina have come back to lead at halftime. We'll be back with more.
Like this, Dick. 14 for 32 as we look at North Carolina, and that's certainly not characteristic of Carolina. Missouri shot 51%, but certainly didn't have enough attempts. And then we look at the free throw line, 11 for 12, Carolina with the trap on a wing. Anytime you enter the ball to the baseline, you can expect the trap.
Chivas first basket.
Hey, Derek, where have you been? Here comes Derek Chivas.
Well, so Brad picks up his second inch hit.
Hey, John, you're upstaging me here. I didn't know you knew that stuff, man. You're researching like crazy.
With a chance at the foul line, but can't hit.
He had great numbers in high school, Sutton. He averaged about 27, 28 points a game.
That's his. He's in his fifth year. Dean Smith does not redshirt players unless there's an injury, which there was in his case. Hardy from outside. Lynn Hardy has 10 points.
I like Lynn Hardy. They discovered him when they were recruiting Demetrius Gore, who's playing for the University of Pittsburgh, and Roy Chipman. Oh, what a screen right there. Gil got ball.
Chivas along the baseline. He traveled. A I'll tell you, Derek Tevis is just not having a good night.
Not at all, John. We've said it two, three, four times. I don't want to just dwell on a point. There he is down inside. Now he's going to try to take the ball to the goal. You know, how good is Derek Tevis? He played for the United States in a World Cup, and we got blown out, so blame them.
That was just one rung on the ladder to a national championship for Villanova as Leonard gets his first basket of the night.
Leonard's going to be a very good player. 7 foot up inside. Guy 7 foot. Now people have these great expectations. In fact, Norman Stewart told me last night, he said, you know what? I made a mistake listing Gary Leonard at 7 feet. He said, I should have said 6'11 and a half like Dean does. I said, why? I mean, I didn't even think of that. But you know what? Dean is so sharp. Most clubs list their statistic. Do it the way Dean Smith, Bobby Knight. Go out and test your club. Let them play against real people. Do you hear me, Bill Frieder? And you see what you're doing. Frieder's got Georgia Tech.
Missed by Leonard, so it went back to a 1-1 again. That's why he's still there. It's not three to make two like the NBA.
He's got a nice rotation, excellent follow-through. And he can't. Some people, especially at home, Gene Katie's team's got quickness, and they play with tremendous intensity.
Tevis gets his second basket. Derek with 6 points. That will be
to make that catch and take it to the goal.
Well, let's follow up on the combination of Hale and Smith as Davis scores from outside. How did
true number two guard? He did. I was at a party which was hosted by some of the beautiful people here who have been so just tremendous to us. Most likely he will be a redshirt this year to develop a little bit more physically, to practice with the team.
Tevis is 4 for 4.
I've been here for a number of years.
Foul shot is up and in by Brad Sutton. The
Steve Bucknall, and have a chance to be in the top 25. In America. Not top 10, the good ingredients of a good club, especially if that kid Strong is as good as everybody says, and he'll be past the championship.
Round three on the back door, got the jumper down.
They're in great condition. North Carolina just, they are so deep, it should affect them at all.
Round three with his second straight basket.
That's why he was the leading scorer. Scored over 3,000 points in high school, round three, but has now taken on a...
You're as deep as Carolina. How do you hold down the score on anybody?
Well, you got to let the kids play. I mean, practice all week long. You don't want to teach your people not to play, and I don't think there's a coach in them. It's so many variations.
Martin was 4 of 6 from the field, did not attempt any free throws. 8 points and 2 rebounds for his first basket of the game. Bucknell applying the defensive pressure. They turn it inside to Leonard. Turnaround jumper off the glass and good.
You gotta like that. That's a positive sign. You look at that 7-footer.
It's been all Carolina. The Tigers trying to keep it alive.
They're not quitting, though, are they, John?
They really are hanging strong. Robin Davis, the freshman from Maywood, Illinois, gets the basket. It's 84-61. But,
you know, we mentioned the kid Davis earlier from Missouri. He had a great teammate by the name of Michael Ingram, who's now playing at Moberly Junior College. And Moberly has a good connection with Missouri, the assistant coach, Rich Dip. I would imagine they'd have a great shot to get Ingram.
Potiff misses the shot. Sutton, the rebound. Potiff gets it back and scores. Mike Potiff with his first basket of the night. At the horn. That's it, North Carolina. An opening round victory in the Great Alaska Shootout over the Tigers of Missouri. 84-63. Dean Smith, Norm Stewart congratulate each other.
There's a lot of wins between those two guys right there as we look at Dean.
As coaches, but when you're in a program such as ours, we demand a great deal, and we expect a great deal, and we want the player to expect something from himself and demand something from himself. And from that comes a little perseverance and mental toughness.
Bill Gardner is a scout for the NBA's Washington Bullets. He was in Columbia recently to see if Dan Bingenheimer and Jeff Strong have the right stuff to continue their careers past their years at Mizzou. And Gardner is very aware of the Tiger tradition in that department.
Norm is an excellent coach, and the thing that Norm does well is teach him how to play some defense. And I think another thing that Norm does well is that he tries to make him a complete basketball player. He's very, very well-disciplined teams, and I think this is good for him.
Three former Tigers are currently mixing it up with the best in the NBA. Larry Drew of the Sacramento Kings, Steve Stepanovich of the Indiana Pacers, and John Sundvold of the San Antonio Spurs. Drew was the first-round choice of the Detroit Pistons in 1980 and has moved on to the Kings. This year, he is the fourth leading scorer on the club, averaging almost 13 points and 5 assists per game.
Larry Drew did very well as a freshman. Sophomore and junior year, he was a scorer and a leader for us. His senior year, he was a leader, and he came into that year with Steve Bowe, Sun Bowe, Curtis Berry, Ricky Frazier, Mark Dressler, team that beat Notre Dame, and Larry Drew is one of my favorites. He wore the number that I had the opportunity to wear, and so it'll be nice someday to get my number retired because he's the guy who's going to do it.
In 1983, the Indiana Pacers made Steve Stepanovich the second player taken overall in the draft. He has shown steady improvement each season and is averaging more than 14 points and 8 rebounds this year. As far as his years at Mizzou, he still holds the Tiger all-time scoring record.
The most highly recruited player ever to play at the University of Missouri. While he was here, we enjoyed the most success over a four-year period. An outstanding basketball player and a very good student and a person that I really, other than basketball, will always remember because he always took so much time with everybody, and that included the fans and the kids and everybody that came to the ball game, and he was a pleasure to work with.
John Sunvold is the second leading all-time scorer for the Tigers. The Seattle Supersonics made him their first-round pick in 1983. With Sunvold and Steve Bowe, Missouri was the only school to produce two first-round picks that year. Sunvold has since moved on to the San Antonio Spurs, where he is enjoying his best season yet, 7 points and 4 assists a game. John credits the Tiger basketball program for much of his success on the court.
Coach Stewart is an excellent teacher of the game. And I think that a big difference for me, as opposed to other players from other programs, I seem to know a lot more. And not saying that it's a big difference, it's just that the basics are so well taught here. And fundamentally, you can beat a player if you know footwork and things like that, which are well taught in Missouri.
John feels his years as a Tiger bettered him off the court too, which also helps in the hectic world of the NBA.
Stewart, you never could probably thank him enough or give him enough credit. He lets you mature as an individual. And basketball is a small part of what he teaches, I think. He puts a lot of maturity on guys as far as guiding them along the way.
Sunvold, Stipo, and Drew. Just three of the Tigers who have been guided along the way to the NBA. Ken Davinsky reporting for the Norm Stewart Show.
We received a lot of...
Well, University of Missouri men's basketball banquet. Coaches and their wives, players and fans get together to all say thanks to one another for being involved in Mizzou basketball. The MC for the evening, Rod Kelly.
Rod, here we are at the basketball banquet for the Missouri Tigers. A 20-win season. What was the high point for you?
Well, I thought the real high point was after we got blown out by Kansas by 34 points and came back to beat Oklahoma two nights later, 101-88. I thought that's when the team really matured and came together and put together a big win and kind of set the program off on a good note for this season.
Rod does the radio broadcast for Missouri men's basketball and says that there's plenty of pride involved in being the master of ceremonies at this special event.
I think it's a real privilege. I've been around this program. I know a lot of these people. It's like going home for me. They have watched me grow up. I've watched this program grow up, and I'm just real proud to be to play a small part that I've had to play in.
Everyone and anyone is welcome at Missouri's basketball banquet, but there's one special group that shows up in large numbers.
The booster club for the basketball team is the Tail Twisters, and this is President Don Mosby. Don, you have a lot of people in attendance here tonight.
Sure do, Randy. We always have a real fine turnout for the basketball banquet.
And who makes up this collection of fans who support Norm and his boys so religiously?
Tail Twisters is just a bunch of basketball fans that are just really interested in Missouri basketball. Been organized for about, ever since Coach Stewart came here. We try to support the team in every way we can, but with encouraging people to wear black and gold to the game, having various functions throughout the year, and just doing the little things that we can to help further Missouri basketball.
In a way, you could call this a fan appreciation banquet, because the people involved in the Missouri basketball program really are grateful for all the folks that get behind the Tigers.
I mean, they've been through the program, they support it through the highs and the lows. I mean, I think like most of our fans, as long as you're winning, sure, they're going to come out and watch. But I mean, these guys will be with you even when things aren't going good. I think that's what a real fan is.
These are true fans. They're here through the thick and thin. They give us such good support, and we appreciate it. We really do.
Oh, they're great. You know, I love to come out here and talk with them, and, you know, they're all so friendly, and they're all wanting to help, and, you know, it's just a great time.
We're here with one of the
most promising fans in Missouri history, and we'd like to ask you, what does it take to be a fan?
Well, it takes a lot of black and gold. A lot of black pants or skirts and a lot of gold tops. That's what it takes. A lot of black and gold.
By now, I'm sure you've noticed how good Missouri basketball players look in formal dress. They say anybody looks good in a tuxedo, but Norm's boys aren't just anybody.
I'm here at the Banquet with Dan Bingenheimer, tuxedo Pumas and all, looking sharp with a great purple and blue bow tie. What do you think about this tuxedo? Oh, a purple cummerbund, too.
Well, we wanted to do something a little different this year, so we figured we'd wear tennis shoes. And, you know, a couple years ago, Prince had a top hat and that, so we decided to wear the old tennis shoes tonight.
I'd be remiss without a coach's comment on this combo ensemble worn by some of his players.
Well, you know, it gives us a chance and gives them a chance, and I think everybody likes that. To see them come out and put their tux on and be involved in this type of situation, I think it helps their self-image, and it's a good evening for them. They have a good time. This is very relaxed, and we have a good time.
And the Pumas still make them, you know, realize that they're still young men, right?
Hell yeah. There's not very many people wearing those Puma shoes with their tuxedos.
Sports banquets like this are commonplace in Missouri, but this is the first one for basketball that's been held before the last game of the season. Coaches, their wives, players, and the diehard fans are all here to celebrate Missouri's great season and wish them well in the NCAAs. Now, a banquet like this is important.
I'll stay if you play.
In fact, in his first or second year, we invited him to the Show Me Classic. We played them on one other occasion, and we had a better result. But let's take a look at this year's ball game in the NCAA.
If the Big Eight felt slighted that every year the NCAA tournament seemed to overlook the conference in its selection to the prestigious postseason tournament, this year they had to feel elated about having five teams qualify for the event. Kansas, Iowa State, Oklahoma, Nebraska, and Missouri all got the nod for a first-round game in the tourney. The Tigers took on the University of Alabama, Birmingham, Thursday, March 6th. The game started much as many of the other games the Tigers had played earlier in the year, with Missouri falling quickly behind, then picking up the pace to eventually lead. This game was no exception. The Tigers trailed early by as much as 10 points, but then a tenacious man-to-man defense emerged, and the Tigers caught and passed UAB, leading 34-31 at the half.
We're going for those pleasures in the night.
Chivas has hit 5 out of 5 at the strike. Good, solid basketball player. UAB sure got the quick start. Missouri just battled their way back into this one. And we are tied again at 20. That's 6 free throws for Derek Chivas. The Tigers have hit 10 out of 12 at the stripe, and they've overcome 9 early turnovers to come back and tie this ball game after being down early by 10 points.
The man-to-man defense, when they made that switch, that's had as much to do with it as anything. They've really done a good job with that man.
The second half was a seesaw battle that left everyone sitting on the edge of their seats.
Jeff Strong fills it up. Strong, his 6th basket of the ball game.
Well, Missouri's got some fine young players, but you better believe that it'll miss Strong and Bingenheimer.
Got out early, led by 10. Missouri came back, got out in front by a considerable margin, led at the half by 3. Now it's seesawed, and UAB's up by 1. Nope, it's Missouri up by 1. Gary Leonard, the basket. Norm Sturt says, go ahead and go to the hole. He doesn't want to call a timeout. Sam Boulder, Hardy, a basket ties it with a minute 5 to go.
They'd like to have Strong take the shot, but they don't want him that far out on the floor when he takes it. There's a good pass.
Beautiful pass. No foul. Nipsey gets the ball and the Missouri turnover. Missouri turned the ball over with less than a minute to go. And here we go. Last 11 seconds of the ball game. Missouri needs a bucket. We'll take the shot. Strong is fouled by Charles. He will go to the line to shoot the 1-1 with 6 seconds remaining.
No, they're not in the 1-1.
No, that's right, they're not.
That's a good play by Coach Bartow. Very good coaching move. They ran time off the clock.
Yet despite fine individual performances, the Tigers found themselves with a 2-point deficit and only 6 seconds on the clock. But they had the ball.
They could make the lob to the big guy.
Strong's going to take the shot. Nope. They didn't get it away. Time will run out. It's all over. Missouri never got the ball away.
But it wasn't to be. 64-66 the final. The Tigers finish up the year at 21-14. Jeff Strong scored 19 points to become only the fourth Tiger in history to score 1,000 points in only two seasons. He followed Derek Chivas in scoring, Derek hitting for 21 points. Dan Bingenheimer scored 10 points, though playing with a re-injured shooting hip. In addition to Missouri, the Big 8 also placed four other teams.